Start it. Yeah.
Hi, friends. Welcome to the episode 2 of our podcast with Nikhil Iyer. And today we have an exciting topic for all of you, and that is leadership. Nikhil is one of the leaders of Mumbai ASG Group, and he's been taking various initiatives of conquering fear, getting out of your comfort zone, which we have discussed in our previous episode. So if you've not seen that, you can check the episode 1 of this podcast. Anyways, today we have an interesting topic on leadership. So, Nikhil,
yes, Ashish.
I would like to know from you, we all would like to know from you, what is leadership, and have you taken, or where have you taken leadership initiatives in your life?
Kishi, that's a very interesting question. So according to me, you know, what is leadership? You know, like the main meaning of leadership, you know, is the person has to lead the way. He has to become a leader, and you know, and people have to follow your what you say, your instructions. People have to follow. For example, as a leader, you should have the ability to lead all the people in your team. You have to become a good friend of each and everyone in your team, and your entire team, they should follow what you say. And also, as a leader, you should have good ability to listen what others speak and what others say. So that is the most important part of a leader, is to lead the way and become and he should have the ability to take important decisions in a team. If you are in a team and if you have 8 members in your team, you know, you should listen to each and every one in your team. You should listen to what they speak, and you should have the ability to take such a decision which will be a agreeable point to each and everyone in your team. And each and everyone in your team should be happy with what decision you make or you take. And all those people, and that is possible only if you become a good friend of each and everyone in your team. And as a friend and as a leader, you should have the ability to lead your team. So this is what, according to me, is leadership.
So you mean to say that use the constructive feedback of your whole team so that you can make the best decisions for the whole group.
Correct.
Like, yes. For example, if someone suggests that, you know, meetups should take place in a certain place, you know, like Bandra or something, so you'll take that as a constructive feedback to help improve meetups for everyone, not just yourself or that member, but the whole group, the whole community, the whole organization itself.
Correct.
Right?
Yes. Yes, Kachi.
Good. Good. So, yes. Can you tell us how have you taken leadership roles in TESA or at work or in your family, in your friends, any one or two examples that you'd like to share?
Correct. Krishi, I have taken, you know, like many examples I can quote, you know, where I have worked as a leader and, you know, I have led an entire team, etc. So, for example, in TESA, the Indian Stammering Association, I have been conducting various hangout sessions in TESA. And, you know, like there are, like, means in the past, I have conducted many SHG sessions at Ghatkopar YMCA, at Borivali SHG meet. So I was the one, you know, who was instrumental in starting the Borivali SHG meet. Because earlier in TESA, it used to happen that we all used to meet at Ghatkopar. And Ghatkopar was a place, you know, it was very far for people who stay at, say, like Daisar or at Basai, etc. So I wanted to keep the meet at such a place, you know, where it was easy for people living at Andheri or Goregaon or people living at Virar, you know, to attend the meet. That's why I formed the Borivali SHG meet. And in, and you can see that in that Borivali SHG meet, there were many, many people who attended the meets right from Virar or right from Andheri and even right from Dadar. Also, people attended the meet. So, you know,
okay, people from, okay, that is actually something, because traveling from Dadar to Ghatkopar is way closer than compared with traveling to Borivali from Dadar.
But you know,
actually,
like,
I'm a bit surprised.
Yeah. You know what, Krishi, people, like, they had a direct train you have, right, from Dadar to Borivali. So people could, yeah, like, easily attend that meet. Like, if you take a fast train, this is like just like Dadar, Andheri, and Borivali. Dadar, Bandra, Andheri, and Borivali. So you can imagine. That's just like four stations. And that's it. So
yeah, I mean, if you take a fast train, then it's like really fast.
Yes. So like, yeah, so there were people, you know, who used to attend the meet right from Bandra, Dadar, Goregaon, or from like this way, like Mira Road, Bandar, Virar also, people used to come to attend the meet at Borivali. So you can see, so it's, you know, it's important, you know, we make our way as a leader. So it is important you take care of your team. Your team becomes your family, you know, when you're working as a leader, or you should treat your team as your family and you should take care of your entire team. This is what you have to do as a leader. You have to motivate your team. You have to inspire your team. You have to take such a decision which will inspire your entire team. And, you know, and they'll become happy and they want with you, they want to work more and more. And that more goes on and on. And you have to bring that more and that ability you have to bring into your team to motivate them. That is the most important thing. Where you have to take your decisions as a team leader. So I'll give you like another example. Mm-hmm. So it happened that long time back we met at YMCA in Ghatkopar, and we were just three people in that SHG meet. Me, Vishal Mishra, and Saurabh Pandey. And he was very new to SHG meet. It was Saurabh's first meet, okay? And we all, you know, on that particular day, we had to do outdoor activities. And, you know, we met more than 100 people in just 2 hours of time. And imagine, we went to the Ghatkopar market, we went to our city mall, we spoke with many people about...
People can't talk to one person, you know, as a PWS talking to one person, especially for a man to speak to a woman or for a woman to speak to a man. It takes a lot, and you know, you've made them meet 200 people. Amazing confidence, I think, they must have gained.
So on that particular day, we met many groups, you know, and they were all people who were non-stammerers, and we were people who had blocks, and we had blocks, and you know, and when we spoke to them, free of mind, you know, we just intended and we just spoke to them what we had inside our mind, and you know, like we had to spread awareness, you know, because I don't think there are many people who know what is stammering. We have to, you know, it's our duty, you know, to create awareness about stammering. We should, you know, we should just go and talk to everyone about stammering. We have to have that ability inside us where we need to speak about stammering more and more. So this is how, you know, we can create awareness, and also, you know, indirectly we are helping many people who are facing this issue of stammering, you know. Because when we are meeting someone who is a non-stammerer, you know, and we always tell them, ki, if you see any person who stammers, just ask them to meet us. Or, you know, or we wish to give our pizza card to them.
Pizza card.
Yes. So, you know, like indirectly that helps a lot. This is how we should do.
Nice. And you know, it takes a lot of courage, because what I've seen is that leaders usually do something that the rest don't. People are running in one direction, leaders run somewhere else, and then these people, they follow the leader. So I can see that you've shown some leadership qualities. That also brings me to the last and final question that we have for our session.
Yes, session.
How was your first day at work? Tell us about that. Since you're a PWS, even I'm a PWS, you know, the first day of work when we are new in a professional environment, I can say that, you know, it's really hard, you know. So share Krishna, your story.
Yeah, I know, Krishna. That's a nice question, I must say. So, you know, Krishna, I always believe that what we... do in TISA, in the Indian STEM Association, we have to practically apply all those things in our professional life. And you know, this is what I did. You know, in my work, on the very third day of my office, I wore the TISA t-shirt, the Indian STEM Association t-shirt, to my office. And you know, I told everyone that I'm a person who stammer. And you know, and I also found two people who also like me. And I added them both to the TISA group, you know.
Okay.
You know, like the main, most important thing is, you know, we have to make our weakness our real strength. And that ability we should possess inside us. And, you know, in work also, you know, in my office, everyone knows that I'm a person who stammers. And I'm very free, you know, to express about my stammering. Because I don't fear about my stammering anymore. In fact, you know, when I get a block, I'm very happy about it, and I'm getting a block, you know, and that happiness is your real acceptance, and that acceptance you have to bring inside you. you know, like, and this acceptance is your happiness, is your inner satisfaction that is there with you. So even in my office also, you know, I'm very free to speak to everyone, and everyone knows about my stammering, about my blocks, you know, and I'm very like free to express about all those things I face in my life. Because, you know, the thing is that as for a person who is stammering, it is important that you should not keep anything inside your mind. You have to freely express what is there inside your mind to everyone, to anyone, you know, to your either to your parents or to your close friend or to anyone whom you fully believe. And, you know, and you should have the ability. See, for a long time, if you keep anything inside your mind, you know, that will make your mind, well, no, it will make your mind have more heavy and heavy. It will make your mind heavy. So, you know, you should have the ability to express what is there inside your mind to everyone. You have to be very free about it. If you are like having depression or anything, you know, you're facing in life, but we as a person who stammer or any person in the world, you know, we should not keep anything inside your mind. You have to speak it out freely to everyone. You have to speak your mind. You have to bring that thing, what is there in your mind, in your mouth, and you have to express it to everyone. And this is what, you know, will make you free of mind. And that is the real acceptance what we are in TISA, we are looking for. For any person who is facing this issue of having blocks, no, don't worry. We in TISA, we all are there for you. TISA is a big family. It's a big community for people who stammer. And we are there for you. We can together, you know, we are together. We can fight it out together. So don't think you are alone. You are part of TISA family. TISA is a big family. And you all guys, you all people who stammer, you all are part of TISA. And don't worry about anything in life. Just go out of your comfort zone. Go out, remove your fear, your anxiety. What is there inside your mind? That is a real stammering mindset. So remove the stammering mindset. Be free of your stammering mindset. And be open about your stammering. Bring an acceptance inside you. You become a team leader. Conduct many hangout sessions in TISA. Conduct hangout sessions. Be a leader. Lead the path. And then if you look yourself back, you will be a different person. You'll be a unique person. And that is the real acceptance. So guys, bring that acceptance inside you. Be a leader. Walk the path. And you'll become a different person. And you will become a wonderful person. And you, no one in the world can beat you. And you will be the winner. Thank you, Krishna.
Definitely, I definitely recommend all TISA members. Number one, start attending hangout sessions. And number two, once you get comfortable with the first one, that is attending hangout sessions, the next thing to do is don't stay in a comfort zone. Get out of that comfort zone and start hosting it. Boost your leadership skills. Don't wait for people to host or people to speak to you. You go and speak to them. You shake hands with them. Take leadership. Communication and leadership both go hand in hand. And today, my friends, I've had a live example in front of you. One of the leaders at Mumbai SHG, Nikhil, thank you so much for sharing your leadership stories. And I can't wait to speak with you on our next episode next week. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. It was a huge honor and a great pleasure to attend this podcast session.